Well, it's no surprise that this time of year, people are packing up their suitcases, heading out of town for some vacation time. As more people make plans, prices will continue to go up, and this week's Your Money is all about saving on some of those expenses. I'm listening heavily. I'm in a travel mood. How busy is the summer travel season, and can you still find a good deal, do you think, Gordon?
Well, I was surprised about this. The TSA says that this is actually going to be the busiest summer travel season possibly ever.
Wow.
Yeah, so that was a little surprise to me, and what was even more surprising is in this episode, we talked to one of our experts. Are there good deals out there? And he's like, actually, there is. He said there's so much supply out there of plane tickets and flights out there that you can still find a good deal on some of the flights. Now, if you're booking for the next week or two, you might not find a good deal. Mm-hmm. But if you're looking at, you know, August or September, there's still some good deals out there for a variety of places.
There's something about sitting on a beach, knowing that I saved some money and then relaxing. It makes it all the better, right? So, okay, besides the ticket, what are some of the other items that, you know, we can potentially find a deal on or save money on this travel year?
Yeah, well, in this episode, we talk a lot about baggage fees. I'm actually booking a trip for later this fall. I haven't flown in a while, and I was surprised to see how much has changed with baggage fees. And now more than ever, it's important to, if you're traveling with multiple people, to create a strategy and to, you know, kind of use fewer suitcases. I'm traveling with five. We're going to get it down to two and have one or two carry-ons for the kids, and we're saving a lot of money by doing that. And we also talk about when you're booking the tickets, look at some of those fees, because they really can change whether or not that's a good deal. Mm. Because it might be the cheapest ticket, but when you look at all of those fees, all of a sudden it's priced out. It's more than you would be paying for something that's a little more expensive for the ticket. Getting to the airport, you save money if it's ride sharing to the airport, parking at the airport, parking off-site, or to have someone drive you to the airport. They look at those four options and the pros and cons of each of them.
Hey, in this episode, you also talk about saving a budget for a vacation. Quickly, what are some things we should keep in mind?
Yeah, I think it's a great idea for people to start thinking about having a savings account specifically for vacations. And in this episode, some of the advisors that we talk about maybe a savings account, maybe an investing account where you can invest in stocks and bonds and things like that. And we also talk about how to create a budget that won't affect your long-term goals. And they kind of take a look at how much money you make and a percentage. Mm-hmm. And, you know, so it's a really good way to look at it so that you're having fun with your trip, but you're not spending so much that you can't put money in your 401k or save for a house or whatever goals you have down the road.
Absolutely. Oh, travel is so important. Come on, treat yourself. Gordon, thank you so much. And of course, you can catch the full episode of Your Money right now on KARE 11+.